one win away after coming back from two sets of Raxdown. Actually, it was just one set of Raxdown as they had taken the other middle end set of Rax. But either way, it doesn't matter. It was a great, great game for you from both squads. Unfortunately for Mama's boys, it was so close for them to break that losing streak of theirs, but they just couldn't quite get it done, as Complexity had a great draft, great leadership at the end of the game coming up from Swindle and the rest of the squad. Really good team fight, so much so that it was so hard for Mama's boys to fight into. Even with having Weehaw's Lina having a great lane, it was just not enough for them to even up the game and, of course, take game number one for Mama's boys. So instead, we'll see game number two coming our way, and already Darks will be picked up for Mama's boys. Of course, my name is Juan. Joining me today, as always, is going to be Pimuckle and Mr. Dr. Pepper Wizard Savage himself, Grant. Grant, how the hell are you, man?
Oh, great. After that game, I'm turning up right now, and just last game, you just assume. I mean, a Naga, a carry Naga, it's going to the late game, the super late game, man. They got this under control, and Complexity just runs a train over him.
Yeah. Pycat played pretty well, but anytime he was in a team fight, he wasn't really contributing that much. He had some illusions. His radiance was good. He could split push. But when it came to actually team fighting, it's not like he was doing a lot of damage. And in almost every situation, they were on the back foot in those team fights. They were going to get, you know, Brutalted on. They were going to get Omni Slashed on. And after that, they had to be very careful with how they played up. Yeah, tried a pretty good game with that active scepter early on for the Tree and Protector, but they just couldn't win a team fight. So it's going to be a bit of a different setup here for Mama's boys. They're going to start up with the Darkseer. They're going to grab the Tiny as well. So a little bit more team fight going their way than last game, I think, for this Radiant squad.
Yeah, but looking at the pool here, Complexity picks up like the two best, like tier one supports in there. Now all you got left is like Coddle and a Kunkka and an Omni. How much does European teams play Kunkka? I know we see DC plays it all the time. Even Shazam plays it, support Kunkka.
Yeah, that's
really
true.
Seen it from European
the only
teams,
teams that team play it are, I think, EG and DC. Maybe a third team. It might have been American as well, though.
Yeah, I've seen Shazam played a bit.
Yeah, so that's a good point. I don't know if they can play Kunkka. They're going to grab the Alchemist, though, which also might be a core.
I think there might be a support Alk looking at this now.
Which is okay. It's not quite as good as it used to be, where the Unstable Concoction was able to, as it was like starting up, it got the extra like armor reduction with the Acid Spray flying through. It just used to be a lot better, is what I'm trying to say. It used to do a lot more damage. You get a medallion. This was way back at like MLG Columbus, and the amount of damage you used to do with that support was amazing.
Yeah, now it's looking at these teams. You got three melee heroes going against two of the best defensive supports. This will interesting. And another Meepo, another ban against Weehaw.
Ooh, they get the Ursa, the all-play Nature's Prophet for Swindle. This Ursa is going to have a pretty nice time. They're going to get a Nightmare. He'll jump in with his Earth Shock, and he'll be able to take down these heroes pretty quickly. Not to mention, of course, Ursa's ability to rush on, but that's, they're more than likely going to do that as a team, and instead of just like the good old pub 5-minute get like level 4 Fury Swipes and your mask and just go to Roche. That's not going to be the case, but
yeah, and $100 says we're gonna see five people from both teams at the bottom room this game, because Mama's boy already, I can show you with the Ursa Nature's Prov pick, they're like, yeah, they're gonna do a level 1 Roche or trick us into it, and there could be a big team fight already.
I would not mind seeing a level 1 Roche, but I definitely don't think they're gonna get away with it if it's this, like, there's no way Mama's boy doesn't check Roche pick.
Didn't they just do it in a Shanghai game Complexity, or what tournament was it?
It was Canada Cup, I think. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I remember they did it. And there we go. Yep, the Kunkka and the Keeper. Looks like it is support, so.
Yeah, I'm down.
Alchemist carry or Tiny carry. One's mid, one's carry.
Yeah, I think it's going to be Alchemist for Weehaw, which he has played before. Tiny is going to be safe lane for Pycat. And the Keeper of the Light Kunkka is an okay combo. I think if you get an X off and get a Torrent plus an Illuminate coming out, that's a lot of damage, but like, X is the only real disable they have coming out from at least their supports. You know, I guess Mana Leak's pretty good too, but they actually have pretty good disables because Tiny has a stun, you've got Alec with a stun, so it's not like they're lacking on that. I don't know, this is an okay draft coming up from Mama's Waste, dude.
I don't mind. We'll see, most likely a mid hero. We'll see what they mid. I kind of like DK for Complexity here. All these heroes.
Yeah, that would give them extra pushing, which they already have throughout the Nature's Prophet. What else can go mid also is something like Necro, I guess, but that's about it.
Yeah, I think DK's, with his armor buff, he can actually go up against that armor spray too, or acid spray. Armor spray, whatever, same thing.
Yeah. And then the acid spray only reduces the armor by 7, and DK's passive, I think, gives, maybe it doesn't get more than that, maybe I'm wrong.
It did. Level 1, it gives 4 and 4, it's insane now.
Well, they're gonna go for Troll Warlords.
Alright, well, there we go.
actually, they have such good roach potential. So now they also could just kill heroes instantly with the ultimate coming out. Troll Warlord makes it so you don't have to really, you don't have to use your overpower as much. Like you can, you still need to use it, but like the amount of attack speed you're getting, like you overpower, control it, and then overpower again, and that hero's already dead. Probably that hero's just dead essentially. So.
And it's actually gonna be limp on the middle troll warder, looks like, versus the Weeha Tiny. So,
ooh, I was wrong.
I think the last time I saw an alchemist that I really liked, I think it was actually during the Frankfurt Majors when Unknown played it, and they didn't do the Octarine.
Yes.
And I remember even the chat, because I read S Gamers. I try to, and they're like, that was a really good build. Unlike that, the rest of the American European teams, they just don't know how to play that. Here, I'm like, well, guess China hates the Octarine Radiance build.
I mean, I'm not a huge fan of it either, and I agree with you completely. When they played that, it was like Medallion into like Treads SNY, I think. Then another item thrown in there. I can't quite remember the exact build, but
that was that team for you. Unknown, they were crazy.
They certainly were. No. Complexity will head down bottom.
There we go, the 5v5 bottom looks like.
Yeah, you called it, and we'll see what's gonna break. I mean, Mama's boys are going to smoke up, but Complexity will do the same, so two early smokes here. They're gonna look for a team fight. Whose team fight is better though early game, Grant?
It depends with how Complexity just and it's interesting, the TI2 Complexity wraparound even.
Yes.
All the way around this.
Back in the day with good old Fluff Hannah Montana, shout outs to them.
Looks like they'll be fine. Mastery. Oh, Mastery could be in trouble.
Smoke will wear off. Mastery is about to get Nightmare it up. Yep, there it is. He skilled his Iron Shell, of course, which is the general build. Good torrent onto three, but Mastery still in some trouble. There's going to be the jump in with the Whirling Axes, and Hanskin will get the first blood. Acid Spray came through, but now that's gone, Mama's boys will have to back away. They do not want to lose another hero. But it looks like the Bounty Rune was not picked up yet because it's still 12 seconds before the game starts. I'm losing it, but yeah, good first blood coming out, Complexity.
That was interesting. Masker is the only one who ran back that way instead of running to the left, the mid lane. And yeah, good 5-man torrent though, but after a 5-man dazzle heal. There we go, 1-0 for Complexity. Both mids get their Bounty Rune though.
Yeah, and that will give a great start for Hanskin. That gets him up to, it doesn't give him that much experience because you share it five ways. It's not that great, but at least he does get the first blood, getting him some extra gold, and they will go ahead and deal with this Darkseer down to the bottom lane. He probably will get killed again, actually, with a Nightmare up and Ursa jumping in with an Earthshock. Until he gets his level 2 with his Iron Shell, he is very susceptible to dying.
Yeah, he's got to sit back right here. He'll just die again.
Meanwhile, top lane, Complexity will pull the creeper. Oh, he misses it. He kind of pulls it a little bit. Bottom lane. Yeah, Mastery just has to sit back and try to leech this experience. Pops the Iron Shell and Swindle just denies all the creeps and he's fine. Swindle's functioning as the one position this game, and Chessy will play the Nature's Prophet, which is very interesting.
Poor Darkseer, he's got the Mastery looking for team tag on in his thing, and he's just getting obliterated by these supports on Complexity.
Yeah, it's not great. Chessy top lane won't have the best start either, because there's a Manly coming out, so he'll take a little bit of mana loss. No stun though, Weeha against Tiny mid, which is, this is like a very odd matchup. You see this in a pub, you never see this in a pro game. It's been a while. In fact, I don't know if I've ever seen this in pro Dota.
I'm sure there's been like an IO Tiny versus a Troll during the Troll patch. Oh, middle limp though is gonna be in a lot of trouble here.
Chessy's gonna die top as well. It looks like the last right click will come through. Illuminate comes in and Z Freak gets the heal off, but it's not enough. Back mid. Limp was able to do some damage and stay alive against Weeha and crew, but that is gonna be your second blood for PyCat and the rest of the crew. They actually skilled up the early stun, and so Chessy falls early. So this is not gonna be an easy offlimp for him. In fact, it's probably gonna be a little bit harder than Mastery's, although Mastery actually just can't find any experience whatsoever. Dear Lord.
Yeah, he uses his last Iron Shell on himself, trying to chase Hanskin away, but Hanskin already has boots. This is gonna be rough for Orange. Both off lanes. I think it's who dominates the middle lane. Limp's doing a good job.
Yeah, but as the game progresses, it might get a little bit easier for the Tiny to last hit and to find kills as well, with a little bit of help coming up from the Ash with the X marks. We'll see. Down bottom, Swindle just runs after Mastery, gets off like one Fury swipe, and is like, alright, well, let's just go back to laning now. I better get some more experience in gold while Mastery's still sitting at level 1. Mastery's just like, I can't do anything. Toss back, Limp is going for the kill on the Weeha. I think he used the ranged Rolling Axes to try to bring him down, but wasn't able to do so. He'll salvage. He also has a double damage rune bottled as well, so I also like the fact that they could rotate Zeke for top lane this aggro trial, and it doesn't need to be an aggro trial because they're still really doing a great job against Mosquery. He's even going to throw up the Iron Shell onto the Wild Wing Ripper, I believe. This might be some experience.
Yeah.
It's not working out. Well, Limp is, they're trying to get him past their tower with a toss, and it's just not been the best play. Weehaw's just, he's gone fishing. Sadly, he's not gotten a hook. Yaps is looking for an X marks. Can't quite find it. Keep checking back towards that Nidalee, because I feel like something's going to happen eventually. But... oh, look at that heal on the Pycat top lane. How much damage he took from that? Dear lord, Chessie walks in, Z-Freak has level 2 heal with nothing else skilled up. Nightmare on Demoskri, he is still at level 1, the same experience we saw from minute 0, essentially. And he can't get anything done. I feel like this is a great landing phase for Complexity right now, Grant.
It is. There's... how does it... Darks here only have 20 experience. He should be going to the small camps doing something, because he is literally getting nothing.
I mean, he gets a soaring recipe. Yay! I have one of three components for... at least a decent item. The Yapsor's gonna walk through in the tree line. They've got X marks of Torin. Houndskid might actually find himself in some trouble here. And he's gonna have to nightmare somebody. He's thinking about it. Yapsor walks in, right clicks him with the Iron Shaw as well. And he's like, alright, I'll take some damage. I'm gonna back away. Now I know that there's a Koka down here. Mid is gonna be a bit safer. Oh. Avalanche toss! The combo! Not gonna do enough. The Fairy Fire will come through. The Illuminate will fly as well. Lip's gonna try to turn on this. And he's gonna go down. Get the bash! But still will not be able to live as the Z-Freak was going to come in to heal him, but unfortunately couldn't get there in time. Still, Weehaw gets to toss him. Chessie might fall. The South coming up from Weehaw. They're going to get two kills here. It looks like they don't have Avalanche. They don't have the mana for it. Chessie still might be able to survive here. Shadow Wave's not there. One more right click from Soxie will do the job. He's so close. He's going to try to wrap around the trees line here. It's going to be the Chakra Magic that will get him to kill with the Avalanche coming in. Two quick kills for Weehaw. What an engagement coming up from Mama's Boys.
Yeah, running at a tiny in the river probably isn't the best decision. And Z-Freak's TP was a tad delayed, and we have a nightmare now on the Opsor.
Yeah, Yapsor should fall here. Shadow Wave gonna come through. Torrent was executed perfectly, but still he'll fall nonetheless. It's not the kill they wanted, but nonetheless they'll find one.
Yeah, but meanwhile, Swindle's free farming as well as Pycat. I mean, ultimate benefit insanely from now. If we see the early Roshan and then they like rotate, get a blink on him and kill Pycat a few times,
yeah,
go back in favor of Complexity.
I mean, Pycat is a great start. Obviously, with level 3 Grievous Greed, he's feeling himself to a certain extent. I mean, he's gonna get up an early item, whether that's Rosh, or not in Rosh, rather that's a Midas or Radiance remains to be seen. Chessie's gonna get chased down a little bit, but... he did die, sure, but he's still doing pretty okay. 17 last hits, he's like 4th and last hits right now, and the only one up there is Pycat. Except for the Tiny, he's got 16 in this mid lane. But even with that death for Limp, he's still doing a great job. There's gonna be the Rolling Axes, melee, now the range one comes out as well. The ultimate comes through, but a great Avalanche will stop him aggressing any further. He's gonna try to cancel that. Meanwhile, down bottom, they rotate in with the Nature's Prophet. They'll find the kill onto the Kunkka. And the woes remain for this bottom lane, as now Mosquery is at level 2, but still a while away from being effective at all. Like, he has lower experience and net worth than most of the supports in this game.
And they'll get a free bottom tower here. See the glyph go out. They also, Dire knows they have a ward right where Radiant does in that bottom lane because the creeps aggro to him when no one else was there, so see if they choose to counter it or not.
Let's see. Wow.
Windle's having a great start. For Nursa, nothing much you can ask for.
Yeah, I mean, he's got 1,000 gold. He's gonna head to Rosh. And they don't have a more mess, but they don't really need it with Chessie tanking with Treants. And obviously the Radiant team doesn't know this is happening. They'll know that Swindle's missing from that bottom lane, but they could assume that he's either jungling, he's in the Rosh pit, he's maybe setting up for a gank. They're all mid, by the way. They're gonna surge up there looking for Yapsor. He just limp packs up. This gank has failed, at least for now, but he's gonna walk up again. They're going to send the illusion over to Rosh. By the time he gets there, it's going to be too late. The Enrage comes through. They've got 23 stacks of Overpower Fury Sucks, excuse me. That's going to be Rosh and Aegis going the way of Swindle at 6 minutes and 50 seconds. Of course, you expect that for an Ursa. Still pretty impressive timing.
I don't think he's going to go for the more. He's going to go straight up Blink. I think that's the play.
Yeah, I agree. I think that is the play, considering how far ahead you are.
Especially versus an Alchemist, when he pops that ult, I mean, with an overpowered Ursa, that ult doesn't do that much.
Right. And still, the Alchemist, some sort of tank item, like maybe a casual Vit Booster, or a Sanchinyasha, or Treads. Even Treads would just be nice, because he has no HP right now. Pycat has 845 total HP. He's got 3 armor. So he will get decimated by Overpowering Fury, so you're absolutely right about that.
The Midas on Pycat just, that makes it even worse. He is not, he's not going to have any survivability, really.
Yeah. So when they get this Blink Dagger up for the Ursa, which will be coming here within about two creep waves, this game's going to get that much harder. He's going to start roaming around, he's going to find kills. He can always still go for like a Helm with a Dom and Blue Satanic if he wants to later on down the road. But for now, he's really more concerned about finding kills. They will get the treads up for Tiny, who's not had the best start, but he's actually doing better than Limp is currently. A little bit, not by much, but just by a little bit. And Limp has avoided some ganks, but still, he's just trying to find last hit sound.
Yeah, drums up on Chessie as well. So it's Nature's Prophet. Yeah, TB with Blinker, so they're just going to be looking for kills. That's about it. Trying to stop that farm. And they're just going to be defending Pycat. They're going to go on top.
Now, they're going to try to find this kill on a Z-Freak. He's dropped up the grave. And there's a toss back with the hit to the Tiny. This is almost certainly going to be a kill. Shadow Wave. Oh my lord, he gets the turn! Pycat now is going to get Earthshocked as well. The Overpower is going to apply. The Enrage will not do enough damage to bring him down. But meanwhile, Hans can get to the kill mid lane. So when they'll saying Raffle for some reason, who knows? I don't know.
I don't know how a three-man gank on a solo Dazzle goes so wrong for you.
That was...
That early grave, just it made him think, like, wait, he just graved at full HP, tried to toss him back, and then the creeps aggro to him, like, oh my goodness, Z-Freak.
Yeah, that was a disaster in every sense of the word. Radiant's top tower is would have been even more of a disaster if they had Weehaw or, Pycat go down. Is he gonna jump in? Good avalanche, but yeah, he's gonna get zoned out. He's looking for another toss back. Nope. Oh, Weehaw, you should have turned around. Maybe he could survive Earthshock. Swimwell actually's gonna lose his Aegis, I think. Yeah, he's gonna lose unless he blinks out. Yeah, okay, good job. Yep, there it is. The toss will come through. Chessie TP's in. Aegis goes for pretty much nothing, but. Uh-oh, meanwhile, Thorn's gonna come out, Swindle, he's got the Enrage. They're gonna drop the Ring Rolling Axes, there's the Enrage coming through, Socks will die to the Brainstep and Pycat. Boy, you're in some trouble here. Good Surge coming through, but they get the Nightmare off onto Moskery. Good Torrent as well, onto two. Now Moskery's about to get dropped, it looks like. There's gonna be the Rolling Axes coming in. Iron Chill's gonna be dropped up, they've lost two. Complexity will stop diving the tower. Weehaw about to get a great Avalanche off. He doesn't go for it, though. He's looking to find somebody. Range Rolling Axes will fly. They see Chessie in the tree line. He's about to fall to the toss in the asses, but he'll do so. Now there's going to be a great avalanche out of two. Another TP's going to be coming through. That'll be from the Keeper of the Light. Hansen will get mana leaked up. Now there's going to be the usage of the troll. T plus the overpower is about to fly. Hansen's still in trouble with the toss. They're just using toss so much. Now there's the brain step coming up. Pike will pop his ultimate. Hansen's going to get chased down. He's got TP. The torrent will come through. That'll slow him up. They've got Grave. The usage of the sun will come out here from Pycat in just a moment. Hansen will probably not be able to TP. Toss simplify, and that'll be Weehaw getting the kill. So, actually, not that great of a fight, all things considered, for complexity. It was a little bit too much fighting that 5-man aggression coming out from Omnis Boys, and the ability to toss an avalanche that consistently, pretty dangerous.
Yeah, the tier 1, tier 2 tower still up. They dove a long ways, and they got the early kills on Mama's Boy, but because it's so early in the game, they didn't even have to buy back. They just respawned in 20 seconds and came back to the fight and turned around.
It was not the greatest fight in the world. So I don't know. You know, they're actually getting kited pretty effectively, which is, I think, the biggest issue for an Ursa in every stage of the game, so.
Yep, Troll does. He did end up getting the tower, so he'll have Aquila, Aquila phase, and drums, just like his Juggernaut.
It's a pretty okay start for Chessie. He's, what, net worth currently behind the Pycat Alk, as well as two of his teammates, and, of course, the Weehaw Tiny. Speaking of the Pycat Alk, he has picked up his treads now. He's already back up to 1,400 gold. If he had died a couple of times, I'd say that this has not been a great start for him, but he's done just fine in getting farm. I don't think he's died once. He has three assists, so...
Like Swindle, bringing the 11-minute clarity for these long, drawn-out fights, especially against Manaleak. This Manaleak's killing him, like, all of them.
It's a pretty big problem, and until they get BKBs later on down the road, it's going to continue to be a problem. I don't know, man. This feels like a lot like last game. Like, Mama's Boys are behind, but they have a really good farming hero that can take the game late and do really well in the late game. That seems to be the case this game, at least for now. I mean, it's only 11 and a half or 12 minutes into the game, but still, you know.
Yeah, this Dazzle's gonna make the biggest difference. Healing Engraving against a Tiny. It almost makes Tiny not go... I mean, Tiny is gonna go Blink, but it changes the complexion of that. He just gets the early Grave and that Blink. Tiny just doesn't do much.
I mean, he'll try to find kills with it, but if the Grave comes out in time, save some teammates. Take the instance here.
Darkseer just still level 6, trying to find some farm in the jungle now.
God. I thought with some room he would have gotten some experience, but that is not the case whatsoever.
That's and he went wall at 6 too.
Yeah. It's kind of interesting actually, but there's the blink. They also get up a Shadow Blade for Flycat, which has been picked up, which could turn into a Silver Edge. For now, it's just going to be a Shadow Blade. How do you feel about this pickup?
I'm fine with it. They're going to do the same thing. They're going to try to pick up kills with that Lothar's into stun and just move around the map. It also helps. They can't kill him without buying dust, but Nature's Prophet TP dust is a pretty common thing, so
yeah.
I'm fine with it.
And once they see the Shadow Blade up on him, they'll bring dust, I imagine, but for now they haven't actually spotted it. They're going to try to split push into this mid-tier 2 tower. They've got 4 heroes here. I feel like they could take this if they wanted to. They don't have Aegis anymore. They have to maybe be a bit more careful, but wait and see if that's going to be the case. Limple will just clear up the creep wave. The next one's coming through. Top one's going to be just at least giving some room for Monster. He's going to be heading towards that nook, unsurprisingly. Speaking of mech, are they going to go for it on Complexity side? Not yet.
Yeah, I mean, I assume that's probably what Dazzle will get next. Maybe not. Maybe a Medallion, but...
Yeah, that's the thing. Yeah, Dazzle could go with so many items. Oh, they also see this... Ancient Sack.
Be rough for them. They'd have to commit, like, a bunch of skills to it, and if Radiant's there at the right time, they could just get wiped.
Yeah. It's better that they didn't, because guess what? Radiant is going to go ahead and smoke up with the Mama's Boys. Now with that newly minted blink tag of Weeha, Pycat with the Shadow Blade, and this might be a dead Swindle. He actually needs to leave immediately. There's nobody showing the map, but he is not leaving. He's about to die. Yep, Unstable Kakashi is going to fly. But he blinked, he can't get it off in time. Now there's going to be Toss Avalanche. That is the kill there. The TP rotations are too slow. And that's just going to be an easy smoke gank pickup here for Mama's Boys.
Draft time, yeah, they should be able to get the free tier 1 top now. Teal's just pushing bottom by himself this whole time, getting farm, getting levels.
And Complexity are going to walk through an Invisible Ward, which means that Soxa knows when to back immediately. And it's just going to give him some more room for that top lane. And Pycat will go to work on this already now with 637 gold after picking up that Shadow Blade, getting that kill. Weeha's going to be going for the drum of his own self, and he's going to have that pretty soon. Masquerade gets level 8 because of that, and that's some extra gold. But they're going to have to defend the tier 2 tower now as Chessie is pushing, and he's going to be going for an Aghanim Scepter. TP's going to come through forward from Weeha. He's going to look for a blink. He's going to find Onskin. There's the Avalanche toss. We'll not get the combo off, but still, it's a lot of damage. Brain Sap will go. X-Marks will fly through. There's going to be the boat coming in. And they'll lose that hero. They did a decent amount of damage to Weeha, and they're actually going to find yet another one as Dazzle gets caught out. There's going to be a trap jump, and Swindle's going to go for the kill. It's not the best idea. The wall's going to get dropped down. The Enrage is going to go, and Swindle is about to get decimated. There's the Unstable Kakashi going, and Swindle will lose his life again after respawning to Pycat, who picks up a double kill. That was not their fight, and they decided to take it nonetheless, though.
Yeah, Z-Freak was a tad bit out of position, or by the tier 2, and then Swindle blinks in, there's a lot of people. We have an X, oh no, Chessie.
Chessie TP back home, only to get X marks back towards that bottom river area. Chessie will get the Unstable Concoction right on top of him with the Acid Spray. The X marks goes yet again, and Yapzor making these plays with the help of his squad. And now 4 quick kills that are unanswered go the way of Mama's Boys.
Dang, yeah, X mark, god, that's such a... How he started doing the Kunkka support again, look, it just looks so good, especially for Sephirion, just keeps trying to TP out and just gets X'd.
Yeah, pretty damn solid. And because of that, they've now actually had a bit of an advantage. Monstery is going to go ahead and surge himself away. I don't feel like this troll has accomplished a whole lot. I'm sure that's not the only reason why Complexity are doing poorly, but it just feels like he's not done anything this game so far, Grant.
Yeah, I mean, the troll's not really... so hard to do team fights with him now with after he got nerfed super hard, and they want to push, but you can't push for a Sakatlin and Tiny. Acid Spray, it's just...
It's very difficult.
They're gonna have to pick their fights, that's it. With the Ursa, they're gonna have to pick these like 5v4 fights, 3v2 fights, stuff like that.
I got Shadow Blade as he was about to get jumped on by Chessie. If he actually had TP'd and used his dust, they would have found the kill, but instead he's gonna get recalled back towards the mid lane. It's at this point Complexity are hanging on by a thread. They'll try to take Roche here in the next couple of moments, but if Mama's Boys decide to smoke up and take a fight, they now have mech, which means they can fight even longer and even harder, and they're already ahead in terms of net worth, only by a little bit, but they can still take a Roche fight if they want to, and we'll see if that is going to be the case. Do they have a smoke table coming out? Looks like the answer to that question is no. They have the mech though done, which is huge.
Chessie's farm has fallen off insanely fast after he got that point booster. There just hasn't been much room on the map to farm. He can't go solo farm anywhere against the Blink Tiny.
They should know they're roaching right now. They have vision up here. At least they should see them around the Ancients Anywhere area. But this is gonna fall by the time they get there. They have to get there essentially right now in order to stop this roach. And that's not gonna be the case. So they'll take the Aegis. They'll smoke out of the roach pit. Yapsu is up on the high ground, smoked up, and he's gonna break the smoke. He's gonna walk right away and try to get out in time. Swindle jumps in though, pops the air shock, the overpower will fly. They get the Fiend's Grip off though, but here comes the boat! And now this team fight, not that good for Reflection. They've already lost Hansky and Limp trying to go to work with his right click. They will lose Dazz on the backside. It's right now 3 versus 5. They'll get at least one. Swindle trying to go for the second and Yapsu. They might get both of the supports here, but on the other side, Weehaw bringing down all of these heroes, at least trying to. Swindle gets low, he still has that Aegis. Rolling Axe is gonna fly. Pycat still up at full health. Swindle will try to blink dodge, but you can't because that freaking unstable production is so damn good. Weehaw will pick up a make and kill spree, and that is 3 down on the side of Complexity. They might lose their 4th with Swindle and the Aegis. Chess is getting chased down, and Weehaw is just running at them essentially at this point. He'll fall, and he will give their 4th kill up, and Weehaw will pick up a double kill with the unstoppable spree. It's just so tough to fight into this squad, and Complexity will lose yet another fight.
Yeah, and Pycat's going for the this straight up run of you fight build instead of the Radiance build, and yeah, they gotta be careful.
Yeah, there's the Maelstrom coming out.
Pycat bottling that up. Good DD. They'll probably take this tier 1 mid now, I assume.
Yeah. It's
Axe first.
Oh, God. He's gonna pop his ultimate here pretty soon, and here's the attack speed coming out. Level 2, Chemical Rage. He's actually taking a lot of damage. He needs to be careful. I'll have to back up here and just wait for him to regen up, but this is the problem. He's not quite that tanky, but they just haven't been able to focus him down. That's a lot of gold, though.
Lane, we have a little bit of fight. Z-Freak getting gone on Graves himself before the toss.
Four staff on Tiny, interestingly enough. You don't often see that, but I guess in this game, a lot of heroes to try to kite, and a lot of heroes to try to kill and get closer to, and I think 4-step is actually pretty good. They're going to get not only that 4-step, but they're going to get it from Keeper of Light as well, and I think they might pick up another one as well on top of that. Wait and see.
Yeah, the last team fight was literally just the troll and the Ursa trying to chase down the supports. Oop, Chessie.
Dude, he got on the boat. Ship, and yeah, the Torrent, yeah, he is done. Great Torrent and Ghost Ship coming up from Yapsu, really well done. This Kunkka has actually done a lot of work.
Yeah, it's good. Complexity is just going to get kited all game with tosses, X's, and all that. And a perfect torn boat at the last fight. You got 3 of them right on the wall.
Yeah. This game feels extraordinarily tough now, even with them getting that last Roche. I don't see them taking another team fight until a little bit later. Even then, it just, they're so far behind now. Well, maybe not so far, but they're starting to get behind here. And that's the biggest issue.
Yeah, and we'll see. It just, in one team fight again, just turns it a grave once they sound like Swindle when they use everything to get him. They're gonna Complexity. We've seen him come back from worse, so.
That's true. The thing is that Swindle just does, it feels like he doesn't do that much damage right now. I mean, because he gets guided, as you talked about. They're looking to try to find a fight here. This could be huge for them. Aegis is gonna get reclaimed in 2 minutes. Weehaw will back away. Z-Freak is in a very aggressive position, which means that Mama's boys seem to know that something's amok. So they'll back away, head back behind this tier 2 tower, and I can see that just split push from top lane, and his Pycat is here. Now the Shadow Blade can maybe try to find a kill on a Chessie. He'll have to do it solo this time, but I don't think that's gonna be the case. And the rest of the crew will go ahead and run towards their ancient stack and try to stay together.
Yeah, Chessie might be in trouble again, top.
Go run up there maybe and just go for the kill. Well, it doesn't matter because Pycat's gonna go ahead and Shadow Blade up. Chessie seems to know something's happening. Ash Sprint will come out as well, and Chase is gonna maybe take a Maelstrom proc. Yeah! Oh, look at that stun duration. He just dies, essentially. Meanwhile, mid lane, Swindle trying to chase him from Osprey pops up. That Ghost Ship is gonna hit on the Hanskin. Now the run will come out and keep them a bit tankier. There's a great back move for the high ground, but now they broke recoil and Pycat. And that's a toss Atlas combo. That's a double kill for Pycat. Now a triple kill with the Maelstrom proc in the right click. And they're gonna chase after Swindle. The force will come through. There's the blinding light. The earth shock will not really do much except for slow Pycat down. Lip and crew are gonna stand behind the tower. Great toss back though from Weehaw. He gets off the enrage. The X marks will fly. The unstable concoction will go a little bit up and back. And Swindle will lose his Aegis and will more than likely lose his second life as well. Carbon acid spray. He'll be able to just earth shock, but still. There's the unstable concoction. The X marks. They're trying to find Lip as well on top of this. Weehaw's chasing after him. This might be all 5 dead. He'll try to TP away, back in, and let's get him caught once more. Gets off the bash, he'll try to right click Weehaw, but he'll end up dying to the acid spray toss avalanche cobble from Weehaw, and that is beautifully done. And Mob's boys now have a huge net worth advantage, and that was a great team fight. I don't know what you do to stop this, but it's not going to be easy.
That's going to be a hard one. Pycat's solo killing your Furion like that, and then just runs middle, and well, he doesn't run middle. He got recalled there, and he's level 16. Next closest is 13 on the mid tiny.
Isn't he CEO? Oh my god.
Yeah, they might. Oh wow.
That was pretty quick. Toss avalanche combo.
And now Z Freak, look at.
Yeah, he's gonna have to use his grave. He might actually make it out in time. Nature's Wrath will come through, but not gonna do enough. Force up. Avalanche actually misses. This is close. No cigar though. Chesky's gonna get torn to top lane, and here comes Pycat. You are a dead Nature's Prophet. Absolutely destroyed. The armor reduction.
First, it does kill Tiny though.
Yeah, he does get the Tiny. He's looking for stocks, so he won't be able to find him. Doesn't have a Bastion to stop the TP anyways, and actually Monster Crew will get out as well. So that is. They had killed him like maybe 10 minutes earlier, this game would be a lot better, but that's one kill after like losing 10 heroes. Doesn't really give them any advantage whatsoever. Barely gives them any map advantage. It doesn't actually.
And also the now that I think about the Ursa and the Tiny pick, that's always just a tough one. That the craggy exterior is so good versus Ursa. I'm actually surprised he got that kill. I didn't see it, so
he's level 3 craggy. He's also going for a Ghost Scepter, which if you know anything about Ursa, and even just the rest of the heroes in this game, very good. It's not that much back damage, and he's already tanky as it is. And if you're getting right clicked down by, you know, an Nature Prop, Ursa, and a Troll, best idea is to get a Ghost Scepter, and he'll go for it.
I think they're just snowballing so hard. He's honestly thinking about just getting an Ethblade here,
yeah,
too,
I think.
Yeah,
yeah.
Especially because Tiny's Toss actually used to be physical. I don't know. That could have been Dota 1. I don't know. But now that it's magical, his combo with an Ethblade is insane.
There is. I've tried this before, back when they changed Deathblade to work on other heroes, but
Chessy just dead again.
Yeah. JJ, I swear he's at top. Maybe I'm losing it, but.
Yes.
Okay, I lost it apparently.
Pretty much, Chessy can't go anywhere without Pycat following around that Shadowblade.
Like, what are you supposed to do with an Nature's Prophet? I don't know, man.
Pretty much. He's actually almost got his Aghanim done out of gold, surprisingly enough.
Yeah. That's the Pyrrhic victory, I guess, for complexity.
He can't be on troll, else. So... I mean, they're gonna have to... He's gonna have to just pop BKB to even kill the Tiny through Craggy.
Yeah.
Oh no, and this could be a bad fight in the jungle. Hanskin is
done. Though. He does get off the Glimmer Cape. Maybe not dead yet, actually. Good Grave comes out, but still. Absor should be able to find his X marks. There it goes, and Hanskin will get caught. He's gonna nightmare himself. Takes off by Iron Shell. He's gonna get Brain Sap off, but he will still get vacuumed back in. He's just trying to juke jab as best as possible to make as much room for a scene. He actually just juked Leeha out of his boots. The Glimmer Cape is about to get off. They see where he is now, but he actually might get out now just in time. He was about to TP away, and if he invaded out alive there, that would have been absolutely amazing. But Mama's boys, it looks like they will take his tier 2 tower and start pushing into the tier 3. And the weave is ticking on them though.
Yeah, Majol. Up on him, 0.28 seconds per attack on that Alchemist.
Right, watch how fast he attacks here. Dear God. Slapchop indeed.
This was just a good game. A great game from the Tiny. He took over that game in about 8 minutes, even with a 6-minute Roshan.
Not really comfortable to take down the Tier 3 tower with Weave up on them. They'll back away. They know that Weave plus Swindle Melons jumping in is an easy kill for the rest of their crew. Of course, they have the Ghost Scepter on at least one of their heroes, but it's not going to be enough. Okay, good 4 steps as well, and really, for Mama's Boys, all they have to really do now is take the next Rosh as it is now up and ready to go. Keep bottom pushed out, keep the rest of the lanes pushed out, and they should be good to go. Like, that's really just all they need. They have Guarding Grooves now up on the Mastery. They have a couple of other good items going their way, and they're going to just look for another kill top on his Swindle, and it looks like he's going to fall. They're going to go in with the Unstable Concoction. The X-Marks will fly, the Thorn's about to go as well. This is a dead Ursa. He's trying to farm out of his base, and sadly will just go down.
And he does have buy. I mean, he's going to have to buy back here. But if he buys back, they just don't have items now.
Yeah, we will go into two heroes, two important heroes. Pycat does, of course, have the AC, but still. He takes down, they'll take the tier 2 tower. They're really just trying to force up this buyback, and they're about to do it. You know, buyback in, Weeha jumps further. Toss that one, he's forgetting to get the Grave off. There's the usage of the Fiend's Grip coming up. Now that wall will come through, the Ghost Ship's on top of it. Hanskin as well as Swindle in trouble. Blimp will come through. They'll try to right-click everybody down, but get stunned by the Unstable Concoction. They'll pop the BKB. Pycat will actually have to leave. He's coming up great, healing him up. Meanwhile, Weeha going to work on this Swindle. The dieback will come through, dead for 71. Master will actually go down. Pike is going to try to ban mode up against Lit, but it's not really working out in favor. Pike out about to fall. We'll stay alive, though, but only for a moment longer. Lit gets the grave off the Z-Freak, and now, pretty good fight so far for Complexity. Lit will get yet another kill, three dead. Wiano gets a rampage as he takes down five. He'll take down a six and get the double rampage coming up from the Tiny. Oh my lord, the toss aver.
That was some sort of fight. I can't believe the Complexity fought that through that so much. The troll almost got it. He was one kill away from a rampage too.
Did he get? Now he can't get another rampage. He'll have to force himself up. The ghost will come through. He doesn't have TP scroll, but he'll blink away in time. Can't actually take the racks down. All things considered, that's maybe the best fight Complexity could have gotten. Riha, of course, being super farm, but
yeah, the fact they didn't lose a Rax there when Swindle was the first one to die twice, so he died, then bought back, then died first again. I was like, well, that's just, it's over, and Limp somehow made a fight that I think Z-Freak threw out like seven heals that fight. Z-Freak kept him alive for so long.
Impressive stuff. And well, game is not over yet.
This is still a pretty big uphill battle. They're looking at Mount Everest here. They are.
50,000 net worth, yeah.
Number three, Roshan, coming out now.
Aegis cheese. 28 minutes in. It looks like Mama's boys are not really in a position to try to fight this. Troll will fly the overpower. This will be an Aegis, and now it looks like Mama's boys might have to wait 5 minutes to try to fight again against Complexity. I don't know, man. That BKB coming out for lunch actually did a lot of work that last fight. Like,
yeah, it did, and Urs is only about 1,300 away from his, too.
Yeah, now with the cheese as well. Once he gets that BKB, they might be able to mount a decent defense, but now with the Moonshot up for the Tiny, that's going to be difficult. Again, Pycat still has that AC. He's got 2,800. They're going to try to fight. Force up Sox is in the wrong spot here, but the TP coming through from Weeha and Crew, rather. He gets off the beautiful combo, and the ultimate coming out from Hanski does not last very long. Naskri actually gets destroyed by Lin. Ghost Scepter will come through. Sox might be next to Ghost Scepter himself. Pycat will stun himself as well. Weeha gonna get caught out here. Now there's the Earshot coming through to pop the jump charge. There's gonna be combo, and actually doesn't get off the cheese in time. So Weeha gets yet another kill going as well. Hanski's gonna try to go toe-to-toe with Pycat. Looks like they're backing away now, but Weeha jumps in with the toss. He'll actually not have the avalanche ready, but he gets a triple. Can he find another rampage is the question. One's getting caught out. The X and the Torm will come through. Complexity are in the last legs right now. Chance will be able to TP away. The Avalanche Limp will not be so lucky. That's the Aegis. Weehaw's gonna back away. He's low in HP, about 500. And Pycat will go to work now. The unstable concoction about to go. Limp is very speedy, but the X marks coming out. He'll end up falling. The ultimate coming through. Look at the damage. Look at the attack speed from Pycat. And it's just too much to deal with. They've lost four. Chessie, the only survivor. I see Freak respawns. They'll lose their tier 2 tower in this mid lane as well. It's just, they can't take a fight, even with Aegis and Cheese. It's just not enough.
Yeah, and this Kung supports just X marks the spot plus Aegis lands. It's, you're halfway across the map and you're getting X'd. It's happening.
He's got 15 assists, which actually feels like it should be more, considering how many team fights he's been involved in.
Mama's boy, all five played really well. After Master had that rough early game, he made it happen. He's got quite a bit of farm now.
Pycat has picked up an Agative Scepter, almost certainly to give to the Tiny. Could also give it to Kunkka. I doubt that'll be the case. He did give it to the Tiny, by the way.
He'll probably give it to Coddle next fight, and they're gonna hear what's fine.
Here we go. Swindle's gonna get caught. The ghost ship will fly through. It'll hit up, and the Hans gonna get destroyed instantly by Pycat and some simple concoction. There's the Earth Shock and a great back wall, and that is it. GG immediately it out afterwards, and now we are up and even. 1-1 apiece, Grant, here as we move into the third game of the series.
Yeah, this is more of what we've been seeing, a little more one-sided games. Last game was super back and forth, but Mama's Boy pretty much led this game. After that first blood, they played it perfectly.
Impressive display of power coming out from Mama's Boys after maybe a bit of an early game kerfuffle, if you will. Not the best initiation, not the best team fights, but still, they end the game with 784 GPM from the Alchemist. Weeha ends the game 18-1 of 11. Way more of an impressive display than last.